They were never late. They never spoke back when they were exhausted. They worked. They never took days off. That they were not that or not on a calendar. They went on strike without permission. They worked 10 days a week and they were only paid for 5. They worked. They worked. They worked. And then they died. They died broke. They died owing. They died never knowing what the front entrance of the First National City Bank looks like. Juan, Miguel, Milagros, Oprah, Emmanuel, all died yesterday and will die again tomorrow, passing bill collectors on to the next king. All died waiting for the Garden of Eden to open upon again under a new management. All died dreaming about America, waking them up in the middle of the night screaming, "Mirror, mirror, your name is gonna win a lottery ticket for $100,000. All died hating a grocery store that sold a make-believe steak and bulletproof rice and beans. All died waiting and dreaming and hating. Dead Puerto Ricans who never knew they was Puerto Ricans, who never took a coffee break from the Ten Commandments. To kill, kill, kill the landlords of the crack stores to communicate with their Latino souls. Juan, Miguel, Milagros, Oprah, Manuel, from nervous breakdown streets where the mice like live like millionaires, from the people who do not live at there. All died never, never alive. Juan died waiting for his number to hit. Miguel died waiting for the welfare check to come and go and come again. Milagros died waiting for her 10 children to grow up and work so she can quit her job. Oprah died waiting for the $5 raise. Manuel died waiting for his supervisor to drop dead so he can get a promotion. It's a long ride from Spanish Harlem to the Long Island Cemetery, where they were buried. First the train, and then the bus, and then the cold cuts for lunch, and the flowers that will be stolen when the visiting hours is over. It's very expensive. It's very expensive. But they understood. Their parents understood. It's a long non-profit ride from Spanish Harlem to Long Island Cemetery. Juan, Miguel, Milagros, Olga, Emmanuel all died yesterday and will die again tomorrow. Dreaming about Queens, clean-cut lily white neighborhood, Puerto Rican-less scenes, $30,000 homes, the first fix on the block. Proud to be in the community of Pringles who went them lynched. Proud to be a long distance away from the sacred phrase, que pasa. These dreams, the empty dreams from the make-believe bedrooms, their parents left them, and the after effects of television programs about the ideal white American family with black maids, Latino janitors, who were all trained to make everyone and their bill collectors laugh at them. And that's the people they represent. Juan died dreaming about a new call. Miguel died dreaming of an anti-poverty program. Milagro died dreaming about a trip to Puerto Rico. Olga died dreaming about real jewelry. Manuel died dreaming about the Irish sweepstakes. They all died like a hero sandwiches that died in the garment district at 12 o'clock in the afternoon. Social Security numbers to ashes, union dues to dust. They knew they was born to weep, and they keep the morticians employed as long as they pledge their allegiance to the flag that wants them destroyed. They saw their names listed in the telephone directory of destruction. The trains return the other cheek, but the newspapers that misspell them and mispronounce and misunderstood their names and celebrated when the death comes and stole their laundry ticket. They were all born dead. They all died dead. need some water.
Mm.